But moving on to other news now, the Imran Khan government in Pakistan has recently passed a controversial ordinance making it so that the country's anti-graft watchdog, the National Accountability Bureau, will be barred from acting against government officials. This, much to the anger of the opposition, the PML and the PPP, who have said that the order protects the government's allies. The Imran Khan government's slogan of robust accountability seems to have fallen short as the PTI government went ahead and made the anti-graft watchdog toothless. The PTI government has amended the National Accountability Bureau's law and its ability to act against government employees. Now, long-standing demands of bureaucrats and traders don't seem to have been taken into consideration. Under the ordinance, the anti-corruption body would be barred from taking action against government employees in case of detrimental deficiencies. Property of government employees would not be frozen unless ordered by the court. And in case of the NAB's investigation is incomplete after three months, the arrested public servant would be entitled to bail. The National Accountability Bureau would only be able to pursue corruption cases of 500 million Pakistani rupees or more. The National Accountability Bureau's jurisdiction will be curtailed as its discretion will be replaced by the Federal Board of Revenue, Securities and Exchange Commission of Pakistan and building control authorities over issues concerning tax, stock and initial public offerings. This comes after a critique of the law around key issues, undue harassment of business community, leading to the loss of market confidence, is what the government is saying. Now, number two, the bureaucracy coming to a standstill due to fears of accountability and some structural weaknesses in the law. And number three reason given by the government, the move has been widely criticized, of course, by the opposition parties as they called for a debate on the matter in parliament. The leaders of the Pakistani Muslim League, Nawaz, and the Pakistan People's Party are alleging that the government has introduced the ordinance to stop NAB from probing mega corruption cases involving the ruling Imran Khan government. With the new ordinance, the anti-graft body would not be able to, say, investigate the matter of the Peshawar BRT and a project that has been pending since 2017 in a PTI-ruled province. And Anas Malik is now joining us for the latest on Pakistan's government amending the National Accountability Ordinance through an ordinance. And Anas, this clearly means that there is no teeth left to the National Accountability Bureau. It means that it cannot punish corrupt politicians.
Well, absolutely, Bhairi. It wouldn't be wrong to say that the PTI government that came on the slogan of robust accountability, they have clipped the wings of the National Accountability Bureau itself. The anti-graft body, which was tasked to overlook the quote-unquote corruption allegations of politicians or even the bureaucracy as well. Now, this latest ordinance that has been issued over the weekend, it has irked a lot of controversy. It has sparked a lot of controversy as well, with the opposition going all out and rejecting this ordinance. Now, this ordinance basically bars the National Accountability Bureau, which is an autonomous and indigenous body, from taking action against bureaucrats and those politicians as well who are basically not found of corruption that is lower to that of 50 crore PKRs. Additionally, bureaucrats would not be subjected to any inquiry if there are any procedural lapses. Remember, this has been a demand of the Pakistani bureaucracy that because the National Accountability Bureau have been going against them because of these procedural lapses, they haven't been able to function properly, and that has been cited as a reason that the investors are not coming into Pakistan and that there haven't been any greater trade opportunities. So the Imran Khan government has enforced this presidential ordinance. As I said, it has sparked a lot of controversy. Right. There would be some beneficiaries, but by and large, the far most beneficiary would be the Imran Khan government itself, right, in the Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province, which would basically not face the inquiry of the Peshawar BRT project. Now, if you talk about this, these inquiries being handed over, it would now be overtaken by the FIA, which directly falls under the federal government. So it does hint that there would be some sort of selective accountability which the federal government, right, wants a control over, precisely while it goes after the opposition parties. Yes, Bhairavi.
All right, Anas, thanks very much indeed for joining us with the latest there on that ordinance as far as the National Accountability Bureau of Pakistan is concerned.